हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू द इकोनॉमिक्स क्लास ऑफ प्लस टू स्टैंडर्ड। टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विद न्यू लेसन 12, मनी एंड बैंकिंग। इन दिस चैप्टर यू विल लर्न द टॉपिक्स मनी, अंडर मनी यू विल लर्न अबाउट बार्टर सिस्टम ऑफ एक्सचेंज, मीनिंग ऑफ मनी, काइंड्स ऑफ मनी, फंक्शंस ऑफ मनी, स्टैटिक एंड डायनेमिक फंक्शंस ऑफ मनी, सप्लाई ऑफ मनी। And in the commercial bank, you will learn about meaning, function and money or credit creation by the commercial banks. In the central bank, you will learn about the meaning of central bank, necessity, distinction between the central and commercial banks, functions of central bank, controller of money supply and credit. First of all, we will start with the key terms: money, barter system, legal tender money, लिमिटेड लीगल टेंडर मनी, अनलिमिटेड लीगल टेंडर मनी, बैंक मनी, डिपॉजिट मनी, फिडिशरी मनी, ऑप्शनल मनी, क्रेडिट मनी, टोकन मनी और फ्लैट मनी, स्टैंडर्ड मनी एंड नियर मनी। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल स्टार्ट विद द टर्म मनी। स्टूडेंट्स, व्हेन यू गो टू द मार्केट टू बाय एनी कमोडिटी लाइक वेजिटेबल्स और एनी ग्रोसरी और एनी पेन, पेंसिल और कॉपी, हाउ यू विल buy this from the shopkeeper? By giving money to the shopkeeper and you will get the things. Like if you want to buy a cello pen worth rupees 5, you will give rupees 5 to the shopkeeper and take the pen from the shopkeeper. So rupees is the currency of India, that is known as a money, that can be exchanged for the commodity. So different countries having different currencies, like rupees in India, dollars of America, pounds of Britain, yuan of China, Baisa of Muscat, South African currency rand, and Turkey currency, that is lira, which is used to purchase the different commodities and plays an important role in an economy. Prices of different commodities are quoted in terms of monetary units. Like if you want to buy cauliflower, you will pay the price of the cauliflower according to the per kg. Like per kg cauliflower rate, it is rupees 10. 1 meter piece of cloth worth rupees 100. 1 liter milk, that is worth rupees 40. A pair of shoes, that is worth rupees 1200. And income paid to the engineer or the cobbler or the doctor, teacher, chartered accountant or any other person, that will also be given in the terms of money. So the main function of the money is to facilitate the goods and services. Barter system. Barter system means when there is no role of the money in the economy, only goods are exchanged for the other goods. Like one person is having apple and he wants to take banana, and another person is having banana and he wants to take apples. So they both will exchange their commodities with each other. That is known as a barter system. Here also you can see one person is having a basket of fruits and another person is having a hen, and they both want to exchange their commodities. That is known as barter system. So when we exchange 10 kg of wheat for 5 kg of rice, it means that 1 kg of rice value, it is equals to the 2 kg of wheat. A doctor was paid wheat and sugar as a payment for his or her services. This is known as a barter system. So barter system refers to the system of exchange where goods and services were exchanged directly for other goods and services. Next one is legal tender money. Like rupees is the legal tender money in India, dollar is a legal tender money of America, pounds is the legal tender money of Britain, taka is the legal tender money of Bangladesh, yuan is the legal tender money of China. So legal tender money is issued by the monetary authority of a country. It has legal sanction of the government and every individual can use it for the exchange of goods and services. Limited legal tender money, as coins, like 50 paisa coin, coin of 2 rupees, coin of 10 rupees, are all the legal tender money in India up to a sum of rupees 1000. If any person has to make the payment more than 1000 rupees, the another person who is the acceptor, he can deny for this amount in the form of coins. So a person could refuse the payments in small coins beyond the maximum limit of rupees 1000 because it is very difficult to count the small coins for big amount. Any payment above rupees 1000 in the form of coins can be refused. So limited legal tender money can be accepted only up to a certain maximum limit. Next is unlimited legal tender money. In India, all the currency notes of different denominations like rupees 10, rupees 20, rupees 50, rupees 100, rupees 200, rupees 500, rupees 2000 are all unlimited legal tender money. So unlimited legal tender money is that which is a person has to accept up to any limit. Suppose I have to make the payment to the another person worth rupees 1 lakh. I can use the denomination of rupees 2000 or I can use the denomination of rupees 500 or I can use the denomination of rupees 50 also. So that person can't deny for this kind of currency notes. Now next one is bank money, or known as deposit money or fiduciary money. Bank money is also called deposit money because these are the deposits by the bank customer in their saving accounts or the current accounts. So it refers to the demand deposits at the bank which can be withdrawn by means of bank checks and bank drafts. Demand deposits at banks are also called as fiduciary money as checks are accepted on the basis of trust. Optional money, like checks are there, see the pictures of checks, drafts are there, bills of exchange are there, are the examples of optional money. So acceptance of optional money depends upon the will of a person. So optional money is non-legal tender money, but is generally accepted by the people in final payments. Credit money. What is a credit money now? Credit money is also known as a bank money, like checks, bank drafts, bills of exchange are the examples of credit money. So it consists of the deposits of the people held with the banks, which are payable on demand by the depositors. Next one is in the bank money, there are the accounts like saving account is there and current account it is there. Term deposits are also there. So that's why all these are known as credit money. Bills of exchange means that is a promise that 60 days after the date, pay Mr. ABC a sum of rupees 2 lakh for value received. So this is a promissory note by a person that is deposited in the banks. That is known as a bills of exchange. Next one is metallic money. Money made up of some metal like gold, silver it is there and any other cheaper metal, that is known as a metallic money. So metallic money is subclassified into the two categories. First one is standard money, that is gold and silver. These are known as standard money. And token money or the credit money. Money that is made up of from cheap metals, that is known as token money. Standard money. Rupees is the legal tender money in India. Dollar is the legal tender money of America. Taka is the legal tender money of Bangladesh. Rupiah is the Pakistani currency. So standard money is a legal tender money as no one can refuse it to accept as a means of payment. Token money or flat money. Indian rupee coin is the example of token money. So token money is that form of money whose face value, that is a value printed on the coin, is higher than the intrinsic value, means the value of metal. So token money is also called flat money as it acts as a money under the order from the government. Like I have taken the example of 5 rupee coin, Indian coin. So on the 5 rupee coin, 5 is the face value of the coin. एंड दैट इज हायर देन द वैल्यू इफ द पर्सन विल सेल दैट कॉइन इन द मार्केट एज अ मेटल ही विल रिसीव लेस मनी फ्रॉम द मार्केट बट इफ ही विल परचेज एनी कमोडिटी विद द एक्सचेंज ऑफ दैट कॉइन एज अ मनी फ्रॉम द शॉपकीपर ही विल गेट द प्रॉफिट नियर मनी नेशनल सेविंग डिपॉजिट्स टाइम डिपॉजिट्स बिल्डिंग सोसाइटी डिपॉजिट्स ट्रेजरी बिल्स एंड अदर सिमिलर डिपॉजिट्स आर मनी बिकॉज दे आर नॉट जनरली एक्सेप्टेड इन पेइंग डेट एंड कुड बी इजिली एंड क्विकली कन्वर्टेड इन टू कैश ऑन अ शॉर्ट नोटिस दीज फाइनेंशियल एसेट्स आर हाईली लिक्विड बट आर नॉट एज लिक्विड एज मनी दे डू नॉट सर्व एज अ मीडियम ऑफ एक्सचेंज दे नीड फर्स्ट टू बी कन्वर्टेड इन टू डिमांड डिपॉजिट्स बिफोर दे सर्व एज अ मीडियम ऑफ एक्सचेंज सो नियर मनी रेफर्स टू दोज ऑब्जेक्ट्स विच कैन बी हेल्ड विद लिटल लॉस ऑफ लिक्विडिटी नेक्स्ट वन इज एक्चुअल मनी When the government of India printed money, a part of that printed money that circulate in the economy with which the economy can do the trade, that is known as actual money. And the printed money that is not in circulation and it is only with the government that is not considered as the actual money. So rupees in India like with different denominations 100 rupee note 500 rupee note 50 rupee note 20 rupee note 5 rupees note etc which are used as a medium of exchange of goods and services in an economy it is termed as actual money and money on account because in the registers we are maintain the balance in the form of rupees in terms of money so actual money is that which actually circulate in the economy and is used as a medium of exchange of goods and services. Paper notes of different denominations in India and coins in actual circulation in India constitute the actual money. So money on account. Rupees is the money on account in India. So money on account is that form of money in terms of which The accounts of a currency are maintained and transactions made. Commodity money, like coins of gold and silver, are the examples of commodity money. So, commodity money is made up of certain metal, like silver, gold. Its face value as a money means coin of gold has a printed value of 5 grams. And that printed value is its face value. When you will sell that coin in the market, you will get the same value as it is printed on the coin and is equals to its intrinsic value. Means if you will sell that commodity as a sell that coin as a metal in the market, you will again get the same value. So it is referred to as a full bodied money. Silver coin or the gold coins are referred to as a full bodied money because their face value it is equals to the metallic value. Next one is difficulties of barter system. Double coincidence of want. In an economy it is very difficult to find such a person who wants to exchange the same things that you want to purchase. Suppose a person possesses wheat and want to exchange it for cloth. In the barter system, he has to find out a person who not only has cloth but also want wheat in return. But such a double coincidence is rare possibility. Imagine how much time, maybe called search cost, it will require to find such a person. Besides wastage of time, people involved in barter exchange had also to wait which implies discomforts and disutility. So search cost and disutility taken together constitute trading cost of barter exchange. So double coincidence of want means to find a person who is prepared to sell what you need to buy. Difficulties of barter system. Next one is lack of common measure of value. The second drawback of the absence of the common unit, that is no proper accounting system like liters, kilograms, meters, centimeter or dollars or rupees or taka or rupaya, in terms of which the values of goods and services can be measured and stated. The value of goods and services means the amount of other goods and services it can be exchanged for the market. Next one is indivisibility of goods. Sometimes it is very difficult for a person to divide the things in order to get a small things. Like suppose a household wants to sell his horse and in exchange he wants the clothes and shoes. Then it would be impossible to divide the horse into two parts so as to buy the two different things, that is whose value it is very small as compared to a horse. Next one is problem of future payment. In an exchange economy, people enter to agreement related to the wages, salaries, interest, rents and other prices extended over a period of time. In the absence of money, these future payments would have to be stated in terms of specific goods and services, which give rise to the problems. Like, there would be a disagreement about the quality of goods and services to be repaid. For example, after giving the services by the laborers, when the employer will give the wages in the form of synthetic clothes, and the labor can deny for the synthetic clothes and can ask for the cotton clothes. So these are the problems that is faced in the barter system. There could be a disagreement regarding which the specific commodity would be used for repayment. At the end of the day, when the employer gives wages to the laborers in the form of wheat, but the laborer want sugar or pulses as a reward for their services. So the commodity to be repaid could lose value during the period it has been stored. The lender would tend to be a loser, for example, fall in the prices of gold. The commodity to be repaid could gain value during the period it has been stored. The borrower would tend to be a loser, for example, rise in the prices of gold. Means I have given the gold or I have mortgaged the gold in order to get some other things. What will happen if the prices of gold in future will increase? Then I will be the loser. And if the prices of gold will fall in future, then who will be the loser? Then the lender will be the loser. So we can't measure the exact values of a commodity under the barter system. Problem of storing of value. Several goods like wheat, potatoes, milk, skin, vegetable, fruits and many other things are there that could not be stored for a longer time period. So they could not be conveniently stored for future. Trading cost of barter system. Trading cost of barter exchange refers to the cost of engaging in a trade. There are two components. First one is search cost and second one is disutility of waiting. Search cost means suppose you have a box of chocolates and you want to exchange it for a Harry Potter fiction. You keep talking to different persons and are on lookout for a person who is ready to exchange his Harry Potter for chocolates. This effort may involve lots of time and physical energy. This constitutes the search cost. So search cost of barter exchange implies that physical cost that a person has to incur in the process of searching of a person with whom he may enter into the barter deal. So search cost can take two forms. First one is opportunity cost and second one is cost of deterioration. In the opportunity cost, suppose you have got a chance to get admission in MBA and on the same time you have a offer for a job from a well-reputed company with a package of rupees 4 lakhs per annum. If you will get admission in MBA, you will sacrifice for your job worth rupees 8 lakhs. As MBA course it is of 2 years and your 1 year package in a job it is 4 lakhs. So for 2 years you will sacrifice for 8 lakhs because of course of duration of the 2 years of MBA. So opportunity cost of time spent in search. Next one is you could have done something useful in the same time. Next one is cost of deterioration of the goods like cloth during the period of search. Maybe the color of the cloth will be fainted or it will be torn or anything can happen with the clothes. So quality of cloth can be deteriorated during the search. This utility of waiting is generated during the process of search. The more you talk to different persons, more irritation you develop. You may reach a point of irritation where you may feel that the search is not worth it. Money in India. Money in India is entirely a credit money. It is convertible into gold or silver. Gold reserves kept against the currency notes are just minimum reserves. They are not in proportion to the currency notes issued. So the currency issuing authority is under no obligation to convert it into gold. Reserve Bank of India issues currency notes of all denominations like 100 rupee note, 50 rupee note, 20 rupee note, 2000 rupee note, except 1 rupee note. 1 rupee note and the coin of 1 rupee which is printed by the Government of India. However, it is used by the Government of India also. However, circulation of entire currency like notes and coins is the responsibility of Reserve Bank of India. India thus has followed managed paper currency standard. Definition of money. Rupees, dollar, euro, pound, taka, lira, rupaya are the examples of money. Suppose in India if we want to purchase a book of economics worth rupees 600, we will pay rupees 600 to the bookseller and get the book in return. So money is anything which is widely accepted in payment for goods or in discharge of other kinds of business obligations. Money is derived from the Latin word that is moneta, which was surname of Roman goddess of Juno in whose temple at Rome money was coined. To a layman, rupee in the money in India, dollar is the money in USA and pound in England. But we find economists holding different opinions regarding the different definitions of money. Various types of definitions of money are discussed below. First one is legal definition of money. According to this definition, money is what the law says is money. Next one is anything which the government declares as money is money. Next is a thing will have general acceptability if the law declares it as money. Kinds of money. First one is standard money. Rupees is the legal tender money of India. Dollar is the legal tender money of America. Taka is the legal tender money of Bangladesh. Lira is the legal tender money of Turkey. So standard money is the legal tender money as no one can refuse it to accept as a means of payment because it is permitted by the government of that country. Token money or flat money. Indian rupee coin is the example of token money. So token money is that form of money whose face value is higher than intrinsic value. Means the value printed on the metal is more than the value of metal contained. So token money is also called flat money as it acts as a money under the order from the government. Coins further are of two types, full-bodied coins and token coins. In the full-bodied coins, like gold coins and silver coins are there. Face value and the metallic value both are equal. And in the token coins, like currency of coins like rupees 5 coin, rupees 10 coins, in this the face value is more than the metallic value. Bank money or deposit money or fiduciary money. Bank money is also called deposit money. It refers to the demand deposits at bank which can be drawn by means of bank checks or bank drafts. Anyone who has deposited money with a bank has a right to withdraw it at any time he likes. It is generally given a checkbook by the bank to the depositor for this purpose. Thus, demand deposits are the liabilities of banks. These deposits are subject to transfer by checks or otherwise. Remember, checks are not money but medium of exchange. They are simply the instrument by which the ownership of the demand deposits, means saving accounts and the current account, is transferred from one person to other. So demand deposits at the bank are money. Bank money is also called fiduciary money, as checks are accepted on the basis of trust. Unlike standard money, that is gold money and silver money, gold coins or silver coins, or any other currency of any country. So bank money is optional. Standard money, it is not the optional, but bank money like checks, bills of exchange, drafts, are all these bank money, and these are optional also. Anyone can deny for its acceptance. Near money, national saving deposits like Kisan Vikas Patras, time deposits like FDs, building society deposits, treasury bills, a promissory notes, and other similar deposits are not money because they are not generally acceptable in paying debts. Could be easily and quickly converted into cash on a short notice. So these financial assets are highly liquid but not as liquid as money. They do not serve as a medium of exchange. They need first to be converted into the demand deposits. Means first this money will be shifted to the saving account or the current account before they serve as a medium of exchange. So near money refers to those objects which can be held with a little loss of liquidity. Let's understand it with the help of example. Like, I am having national saving certificate with a maturity date of 1st January 2020. After 1st January 2020, my full amount will be transferred to the saving account, and from that saving account I can withdraw the money and I can pay off my debt. Next one is, we have discussed the topics key terms: money, barter system, legal tender money, limited legal tender money, unlimited legal tender money, bank money or deposit money or fiduciary money, optional money, credit money, token money or flat money, standard money or near money. And under money we have discussed barter system of exchange, meaning of money, kinds of money. So these are the topics that we have discussed today. Hope you all have understood the topics. So students, now it's time to note down the homework. Question number first is, define the following terms with examples: money, barter system, legal tender money, limited legal tender money, unlimited legal tender money, bank money or deposit money or fiduciary money, optional money, credit money, token money or flat money, standard money, near money. Second question is, explain the meaning of barter system with its difficulties. Question number 3 is, enlist and explain the different kinds of money. And students, please go through the links on the YouTube for more clarity, and hope you all will complete your homework on your copies for better learning. Thank you for listening.